Greetings and welcome to another video. In the last video, we discussed how management helps us in different way, like it avoids degradation and destruction of the natural resources, solves the water balance problems, and improves the condition of the resources. Today we'll discuss about management of forest and wildlife. Forest is a natural system that can supply different products and services. Forest supply water, it mitigate climate change. Forest provide habitats for wildlife. It provide timbers and fuel wood. It serves as a source of non-wood forest products, including food and medicine, and contribute to rural livelihood. The protection and management of forest also ensures the management of wildlife. Forest regulate climate conditions, such as rainfall, humidity, and temperature regime of the area, and protect the soil and landscape from wind and erosion. Forest is considered as the green lung of Mother Earth. The world's forest, along with its oceans, absorb enormous amount of carbon dioxide that circulates in the atmosphere. They are effectively the Earth's lung, and protecting those lungs is crucial if we are to protect the planet's biodiversity and fight global warming. The green lung of Mother Earth are vital to our health and survival. So the question is, why it is important to protect the forest? These are some reasons why we should protect forest for our own interest. Forest is the habitat for animals. Forest is livelihoods for humans. It protects watershed, prevents soil erosion, and mitigates climate changes. The forest is a natural system that can supply different products and services. Forest supply water, mitigate climate change, provide habitats for wildlife, provide timber and fuel wood, serves as a source of non-wood forest products, including food and medicine, and contribute to rural livelihood. Many people, rural people, are very much dependent on the forest product, and that their livelihood depends too much on the forest. About wildlife. Wildlife refers to undomesticated animal species, but has come to include all organisms that grow or live wild in an area without being introduced by humans. Global wildlife population have decreased by 68% since 1970 as a result of human activities, particularly overconsumption, population growth, and intensive farming. If we look at the forest coverage of the world land area, forest covers about 31% of the global land area. This 31% of the global forest coverage is supporting all the populations living in this 69% of the land area. So the total forest area is 4.06 billion hectares, or approximately 5,000 meters square per person. For per person, the forest coverage is 5,000 meters square per person. per head we get 5000 meter square of forest. But forests are not equally distributed around the globe. Two-thirds, that means about 66% of forests, are found in 10 countries. And half of the forest is found in 4 countries of the world. Among these 10 countries, India is in the 10th position so far as forest coverage is concerned. Now, forest coverage in India. In an average, in India, 21%, 67% is the forest coverage, but it should be about 31% if we compare with the global average. So 21.6% of the land area is covered by forest in India, and in Northeast the situation is much better. 65.05% of the land area is covered by forest, and rest 34.95% is non-forest area. So according to the Indian State of Forest Report 2019, in terms of area, Madhya Pradesh has the largest forest cover in the country, and next is Arunachal Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha, and Maharashtra. The forest coverage in the Northeast is, although it is 65%, but it has been declining. Except Assam and Tripura, all the states in the region saw decreasing in forest cover. The decline of the forest area in the Northeast region is continuous. Since 2009, the forest coverage in Northeast area are declining. And state-wise, that exception is Assam and Tripura. So, wildlife is considered as a renewable resource, and its management is important if we want a sustainable yield from the wildlife. Millions of wild animals have been killed for various reasons. Forests are destroyed for timber, firewood, and other purposes. In summary, these are the measures need to be taken for forest resource management, like constant monitoring of forest. Constant monitoring of forest growth and depletion rate is very essential so that the necessary management can be adapted to any degradation. Next, prevention of forest fire. Forest fire destroys many forests in some seasons throughout the world. So, prevention of the forest fire is important to protect the forest. Method of harvesting forest product. Adoption of scientific methods for harvesting forest product is very important to protect forest. Next, stopping unauthorized cutting of trees and strict enforcement of laws. Then, adopting tree plantation and maintenance on a large scale is required for management of the forest. Adopting social forestry to meet the requirements of fuel, wood, fodder, timber, fruits, and so on. And last but not the least, creating awareness among people about the necessity of forest for survival of human beings and wild animals. So these are some steps that we can take for management of the forest and wildlife as well. Forest can be conserved by maintaining Biosphere Reserve. There are three methods. One is Biosphere Reserve, National Parks, and Wildlife Sanctuaries. Maintaining biosphere reserves, wildlife sanctuaries and national parks, zoological parks and botanical gardens are important to conserve forest. A biosphere reserve is a place reserved for all life forms found in a particular area. A biosphere reserve comprises of a number of national parks and wildlife sanctuaries. National parks are large and diverse reserves which help in protection of different ecosystems. These can protect flora, fauna, and many other aspects of ecosystem. Wildlife sanctuaries are the areas which help in preservation of species of wild plants and animals. Wildlife management in India. Biosphere Reserve is an international designation by UNESCO. Biosphere reserves are thus special environments for both people and nature, and are living example of how human beings and nature can coexist while respecting each other's needs. India has special designated biosphere reserves where animals and plants are carefully nurtured and monitored for their protection. In 1972, Government of India passed Wildlife Protection Act for the purpose of protection of wildlife. India has designated ministry which look forward to the affairs related to the wildlife, plants and animals. Every year, Forest Department is provided a specific portion of Indian annual budget to ensure the safety of wildlife in India. This ministry, that means Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate, is also responsible for keeping a check on human activities going on in or near the protected areas of India. So, biosphere reserve, national parks and sanctuaries, these are the protected regions declared by the Government of India, and similarly such places are declared in other countries also for protection of the forest and wildlife. India has 101 national parks, 553 wildlife sanctuaries, and 18 biosphere reserves, according to National Wildlife Database, December 2019. And also, India has many other places like private protected areas which are under observation of private companies, villages, and NGOs. So these are some plans and policy in India for the protection of forest and wildlife. List of 18 biosphere reserves in India. We have 18 biosphere reserves in India which are of international recognition from UNESCO. In Assam, there are two biosphere reserves. One is Manas and another is Dibru Soikhoa. And in the Northeast, another two is Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh, and also in Meghalaya. The largest one is the Kutch in Gujarat. So these are some very important protected areas as in the form of biosphere reserves within India. National parks in Assam. These are the national parks in Assam: Dibru-Saikhowa National Park, Kaziranga National Park, Manas National Park, Nameri National Park, and Udang National Parks. So there are 5 national parks in Assam. Out of 101 national parks in India, there are 5 in Assam. Now, wildlife sanctuaries in Assam are, there are 15 wildlife sanctuaries in Assam. This is the list of wildlife sanctuaries in Assam. This one is famous for the rhino, other than the Kaziranga National Park. So there are 553 wildlife sanctuaries, and out of that, 15 sanctuaries are there in Assam. Okay. I have collected this data from different sources, so this data may not be the updated one, so you can get the updated data from the reliable sources. About Act and Law, all protection related issues of forest and wildlife sector are dealt in Indian Forest Act 1927. This act was there before the independence. Next, Wildlife Protection Act 1972, then Forest Conservation Act 1980, etc. So these three are the main act under which these issues are dealt in. India has been participating in several international summits and conventions on conservation and sustainable development of forest, wildlife, and environment. India is actively representing on various international forums on forestry matters, like this, say, United Nations Forum on Forest, Committee of Forestry of Food and Agriculture Organization of United Nations, Asia Pacific Forestry Commission, Center of International Forestry Research, Asia Pacific Forest Invasive Species Network, International Poplar Commission, then United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, etc. So India has contributed positively to the various conventions on forest and wildlife sectors. The Wildlife Crime Control Bureau has been created under Section 38Y of the Wildlife Protection Act 1972. And about the data, as per the information from Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change website, these are the data. There are 103 national parks, 528 wildlife sanctuaries, 65 conservation reserves, and 4 community reserves. So you can get the updated data from this website. That is better to get the most updated data from the right source. So, okay, this is all from my side about resource, natural resource, and the conservation of natural resource, and specifically forest resource and wildlife. There are other resources. Soil is a resource, and there are many departments in India for conservation of the soil also. Water is also a resource. For that also, there are many initiatives from Government of India and from many NGOs also. So that's all from this video. Thank you for watching.